Hi, I'm Chad Wunderlich with Viking Pump. And if you've missed our videos in the past about pump operation, you're in luck. We're revisiting our various rotary PD pump technologies, and today I'll be talking about the external gear pump and where you can find them. You're watching the Pump Report. The external gear pumping principle was invented around 400 years ago, making it one of the earliest pump designs. The design is fairly straightforward, consisting of two gears, a drive gear and a driven gear. They're identical in design and rotate against each other to create flow. And here's how it works. The drive gear is driven by the motor, and the driven gear meshes with and is rotated by the drive gear. As the gears come out of mesh on the inlet side of the pump, a vacuum is created that pulls the liquid into the pump and between the gear teeth. Liquid is then trapped between the gear teeth and the casing wall, and tight clearances between the gears and the casing keep that liquid from moving back to the suction side. The rotation of the gears carries the liquid to the outlet side of the pump. At the outlet, the meshing of the gears forces the liquid out of the port and into the downstream piping. Because of the very tight clearances and the fact the gears are supported on both sides, these pumps are capable of both high pressure and thin liquid applications. This makes them ideal for applications such as hydraulics, pipeline injection, cooking oil reclamation, and glycol dehydration of natural gas. External gear pumps can be oriented with horizontal ports, as our animation showed, or with vertical ports, as the display shows here. They also are some of Viking's smallest pump sizes, meaning they fit in more compact spaces and offer flows all the way down to 0.06 gallons per minute at motor speed. To learn more about external gear pumps or to view other pump reports, please visit our website at vikingpump.com.